Hi guys, welcome to the first two episodes recap of the K-drama Agency. With a plot spoiler alert, let's get to it. As the episode begins, we are introduced to Ah-in, who is a very competent creative director who works in an advertising agency named VC Planning. Jae-jun, who is the president of the game company JH Factory, gets impressed by Ah-in's presentation and hands over the advertising campaign to VC Planning. But Ah-in works in a male-dominant company, so even though she is competent, her colleagues, including Chang-su, who is the chief project officer, consider her a threat to them. Chang-su even tries to take credit for the work Ah-in does, since she works under him. After Ah-in leaves, Chang-su talks with his minions Woo-cheol, Oh-jung, and Ho-young, who are direct peers of Ah-in, about the head of production position that has been vacant for some time. Woo-cheol fancies that one of them will probably get the promotion, and Ah-in will have to work under one of them. Yoon-jung is the newest recruit of the company, and has been assigned to work under Ah-in. To her shock, one of the employees resigns, calling Ah-in a hypocrite who uses her team to get what she wants by any means. She even advises Yoon-jung to leave as soon as she can if she wants to live. Bung-soo and Jung-woo suggest going out for a meal to welcome Yoon-jung, but Ah-in refuses, pointing out that they would be more comfortable without her. Apparently Ah-in has a lot of mental disorders, and takes high-dosage drug for it. Her psychiatrist and friend Soo-jin is concerned about Ah-in being only focused on work and taking the strongest drug. She tries to convince her to take care of her mental health without taking the drug, but Ah-in is not taking it into consideration and relies heavily on medication. Beside her bed, we see Ah-in has a patched-up bunny. The next day we see Eun-jung with her son A-ji, who is mad at her for not keeping her promises and for working late at night. Chang-su, on the other hand, meets with Woo-cheol and is disappointed to hear that he has been drinking all night while letting others handle the project that was assigned to him. Angrily, Chang-su makes a call to Ah-in to arrange a meeting. Chang-su informs both Ah-in and Woo-cheol that there will be an internal competition to select the next head of production. Ah-in is surprised to hear it, and more so on seeing Woo-cheol readily agreeing to it. But she agrees to it, since she wants a chance to compete for the position. Both Woo-cheol and Ah-in relay the message to their teams. Bung-soo argues that it seems like a trick to get Woo-cheol into the position without a problem, since the winner will be decided by Chang-su, since it is an internal competition. Even though it makes sense to Ah-in, she decides to do well with her team in the competition. So she makes her team work all night to come up with a good ad campaign for the presentation. Chang-su is eyeing to get the CEO position when the current CEO resigns. So he is trying to get people who are loyal to him to higher positions so he can control them. Ah-in's team prepares for a meeting to present the ideas they have come up with for the ad campaign to Ah-in. As they arrange, Eun-jung takes out one of her ideas, thinking it's not good enough. When Ah-in gets to the meeting, she takes down all the ideas that her team has come up with and lashes out at them to do a better job, and demands that they are not allowed to go home until they've come up with a better idea. Eun-jung then decides to present the one that she took out as Ah-in leaves. To the team's surprise, Ah-in gives her approval to Eun-jung's idea and to work on it secretively so that Woo-cheol wouldn't find it out. Suspecting Woo-cheol, Ah-in asks her team to paste the idea she discarded on the wall for Woo-cheol to see just in case he sneaks up on them. Ah-in then goes to meet Jae-jun, who is interested in recruiting her into the marketing team of his gaming company. But Ah-in makes clear that she loves working in the advertising agency and turns down the offer. The next morning, just as Ah-in suspected, Woo-cheol sneaks up to Ah-in's team room to see what she's working on. But he gets caught by Chang-su, who informs him that Ah-in will be coming to work soon. Chang-su watches him leave in disappointment, regretting Ah-in for not being on his side. Later, after his team comes to work, Woo-cheol confidently hands his team the ideas he stole from Ah-in's team, asking to work on them, and leaves the office to hang out with his friends, even though his director position is at stake. Later, Ah-in goes to see her former mentor Jung-seok, who now runs a restaurant. He shows him the campaign to get his approval on it. Jung-seok wonders why she's working hard on the presentation, since Chang-su would not let Ah-in be the head of production. So Ah-in clarifies that she might probably get fired after the head of production was elected, and that she wanted to make sure that she isn't getting fired because of not being good at her work. On the presentation day, Woo-cheol is overly excited, thinking that he is aware of Ah-in's campaign, and even decides to present first. Ah-in's team is surprised to see Woo-cheol presenting one of the ideas they threw away, and realizes the reason Ah-in wanted the ideas to be displayed on the wall, so that Woo-cheol could see. Woo-cheol is shocked when Ah-in presents a different presentation than the one he thought she would, and to his horror, both CEO Moon-ho and Chang-su approve Ah-in's presentation. To everyone's surprise, Chang-su recommends Ah-in as the head of production. Members of all teams gather up to congratulate Ah-in, except for the three other creative directors, who are shocked to see the results, and Ah-in herself is in tears. She even decides to treat everyone to dinner. We flash back to Ah-in's early days when she was a rookie copywriter, and she worked under Jung-seok. Jung-seok lashes out at her for doing a bad job as a copywriter. So Ah-in gets into the toilet and starts to cry, and when she gets out, she runs into her senior worker Jung-min. Jung-min tells her to write until she's sick of it, since that is the only way for a rookie copywriter to learn. Taking her advice, Ah-in spends overnight writing campaign proposals. So the next day when Jung-seok arrives, Ah-in hands her a bundle of proposals. Chang-su, on the other hand, seems to be plotting against Ah-in, even though he recommended her as the head of production. Woo-cheol rushes to meet Chang-su after hearing about Ah-in's promotion, demanding to know why he didn't recommend him. Chang-su angrily tells him to wait for his turn. At the dinner treat, Ah-in has a good time with her colleagues, and even shares about her experience in the company entrance exam. She gets home after getting drunk and throws all her medicine into the garbage. For the next passing days, Ah-in has the time of her life, and she gets a lot of attention for being the first female executive of VC planning. Ah-in speaks in an interview and explains that she grew up poor without parents, and even stayed at her aunt's house, even though she was not welcome there. Eun-ja, who is a woman working in a restaurant, painfully watches Ah-in talk in the interview. We are then introduced to Hannah, who is the daughter of Yong-ho, who is the chairman of VC planning, informing her to return to Korea to work for the company as a director. She argues that the reason Ah-in was promoted to the head of production is because it makes a bad impression if the daughter of the chairman becomes the first female executive officer of the company. Young-ho then meets with Chang-su and tells him to assist Hannah when she gets to work, which Chang-su gladly accepts. Chang-su is friends with Young-ho's secretary, who is Tae-wan. He too tries to get Chang-su into the CEO position after the current CEO Moon-ho retires. Chang-su gets a call from Moon-ho, disappointed that he did not discuss Ah-in's promotion. So Chang-su retorts at him that the decision came from Young-ho, but admits that he is the one who recommended Ah-in. Chang-su then meets with Ah-in and asks her to hand over the ad campaign idea to Woo-cheol, since she is now a chief creative officer and the project is too big for Byung-soo to handle. So Ah-in agrees to it. Byung-soo and the team are disappointed by it, but they obey Ah-in's decision. Won-hee, who is the copywriter of Woo-cheol's team, hesitates to take over the project, which Eun-jung is delighted to see. Eun-jung insists, pointing out that it is what their superiors want. Once Ah-in gets to her room, Soo-jung introduces herself as Ah-in's new secretary. Tae-wan arrives at her office and hands her a call from Young-ho, saying she's the face of the company and should work and act accordingly, and should even be concerned about what she wears. To Ah-in's horror, Tae-wan tells her that she's been given the position just for a year, so they would help her to become either a university professor or a CEO of a small advertising agency. Apparently Chun-su has been planning the entire thing with Tae-wan this whole time. On his way to meet Ah-in to get her approval on an advertising campaign, Byung-soo sees Ah-in angrily walking out of her room, and Soo-jung makes a call and reports about it to someone. Apparently Soo-jung is spying on Ah-in and reporting everything about her to Chung-su. Ah-in barges into Chung-su's office while he is with Woo-cheol. They mock her when she demands to know about her position. Chung-su even retorts at her for being too greedy when she is not that qualified enough for the position. Ah-in gets a panic attack, and because she threw out her medicine, she hurries home. On remembering, she throws them into the garbage bin. Ah-in searches through the bin as everyone watches, and takes some pills right then and there. She then remembers her mother abandoning her in a bus terminal, leaving her with her bunny, and her aunt lashing out at her for taking higher grades than her daughter. Jae-hoon gets informed about Ah-in, but he hesitates to contact her and check up on her. The news of the company making Ah-in an executive was just a show got spread all over the company by the next day. Only Byung-soo and his team seem to be genuinely concerned about Ah-in. Byung-soo goes to check on Ah-in. She is relieved to see his loyalty towards her, even though she retorts to him that he would probably go to Chung-su now that she has fallen. Byung-soo is even willing to go to Chung-su and lash out at him for what he did, but Ah-in stops him. Ah-in then goes to see Jung-seok. Jung-seok advises her not to fight Chung-su, reminding her that he was fired from the company after he went against Chung-su. But Ah-in is determined to take down Chung-su and his minions. So Jung-seok tells her to use her executive powers if she really wants to fight Chung-su. The next day, Ah-in orders Soo-jung to get her the production team's personnel files and the company rules file. And of course Soo-jung reports it to Chung-su before getting her the files. Chung-su realizes that Ah-in is trying to get her people promoted. Later after work, Ah-in meets with Woo-cheol and the other directors and pours them drinks, saying they should start over. Woo-cheol and his friends are delighted to see Ah-in's sudden change. When Woo-cheol gets to work the next day, he is shocked to see that he, Oh-jun, and Ho-young has been demoted. The episode ends as the angry men rush to Ah-in's office as Ah-in waits for them. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.